Christ on my left hand, Christ all around me, shield in the strife, Christ in my sleeping, Christ in my sitting, Christ in my rising, light of my life. Christ be in all hearts, thinking about me. Christ be in all tongues, telling of me. Christ be the vision in eyes that see me, in ears that hear me, Christ ever be.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Grace to you and peace from God, our Father, and the Lord Jesus Christ.
And with your spirit.
Good morning, everyone. Good morning. This morning we've moved off the main sanctuary to the devotional area at the back of the church. And for a number of years, the statue of St. Patrick has been here. Today we celebrate his feast day. The parish, when it opened in 1877, was opened because of an influx of mainly Irish immigrants in order to work in the local coal mines. The Catholic community swelled greatly, and the first Miners' Row Church was opened, and then a few years later, the church that occupies the site where the hall is just now. And then in 1905, the present Church of St. Joseph was opened. But St. Patrick was always and has always been a well-loved saint within this community, the people conscious of our Irish roots and the debt that we owe to the Irish Church for the flourishing of the Church in the 19th and 20th century. Patrick was ultimately a missionary. One thing that all of the traditions agree with is that he was not Irish. The Welsh claim him, the English claim him, and of course we in Scotland know that he was a Scotsman and was taken in slavery to Ireland. He got his freedom. He escaped, but he returned again in order to evangelize the people of Ireland. And he was a great pastor and a great leader. That hymn I sang at the beginning was from the breastplate of St. Patrick, and it reflects Patrick's spirituality, that Christ is all around us. So let's pray as we celebrate this Mass today that we will recognise that presence of Christ as we celebrate this Eucharist together and as we face difficult times. Let's pray that that example that St. Patrick has given, the example of courage and that willingness to go out and proclaim the good news to all people, that we too will share in that enthusiasm. To prepare ourselves to celebrate then the sacred mysteries, let's call to mind our sin. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, and you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who chose the Bishop St. Patrick to preach your glory to the people of Ireland, grant through his merit and intercession that those who glory in the name of Christian may never cease to proclaim your wondrous deeds to all. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. A reading from the prophet Jeremiah. The word of the Lord is addressed to me, saying, Before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. Before you came to birth, I consecrated you. I have appointed you as prophet to the nations. I said, Ah, Lord, look, I do not know how to speak. I am a child. But the Lord replied, Do not say, I am a child. Go now to those to whom I send you, and say whatever I command you. Do not be afraid of them, for I am with you to protect you. It is the Lord who speaks. Then the Lord put out his hand and touched my mouth and said to me, There, I put my words into your mouth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Go out to all the world. And tell the good news.
Go out to all the world and tell the good news.
O praise the Lord, all you nations. Acclaim him, all you peoples.
Go out to all the world and proclaim the good news.
Strong is his love for us. He is faithful forever.
Go out to all the world and proclaim the good news.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Paul and Barnabas spoke out boldly to the Jews. We had to proclaim the word of God to you first, but since you have rejected it, since you do not think yourselves worthy of eternal life, we must turn to the pagans. For this is what the Lord commanded us to do when he said, I have made you a light for the nations, so that my salvation may reach the ends of the earth. It made the pagans very happy to hear this, and they thanked the Lord for his message. All who were destined for eternal life became believers. Thus the word of the Lord spread through the whole countryside. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Praise to you, O Christ, King of eternal glory. Praise to you, O Christ, King of eternal glory.
The Lord sent me to bring good news to the poor and freedom to prisoners.
Praise to you, O Christ, King of eternal glory, praise to you, O Christ, King of eternal glory.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The Lord appointed 72 others and sent them out ahead of him in pairs to all the towns and places he himself was to visit. He said to them, "The harvest is rich, but the labourers are few. So ask the Lord of the harvest to send labourers to his harvest. Start off now, but remember, I am sending you out like lambs among wolves. Carry no purse, no haversack, no sandals. Salute no one on the road. Whatever house you go into, let your first words be, 'Peace to this house.' And if a man of peace lives there, your peace will go and rest on him. If not, it will come back to you. Stay in the same house, taking what food and drink they have to offer, for the labourer deserves his wages. Do not move from house to house. Whenever you go into a town where they make you welcome, eat what is set before you. Cure those in it who are sick and say, 'The kingdom of God is very near to you.' But whenever you enter a town and they do not make you welcome, go out into its streets and say, 'We wipe off the very dust of your town that clings to our feet and leave it with you.' Yet be sure of this, the kingdom of God is very near. I tell you, on that day it will not go as hard with Sodom as with that town." The 72 came back rejoicing. "Lord," they said, "even the devils submit to us when we use your name." He said to them, "I watched Satan fall like lightning from heaven. Yes, I have given you power to tread underfoot serpents and scorpions and the whole strength of the enemy. Nothing shall ever hurt you. Yet do not rejoice that spirits submit to you. Rejoice rather that your names are written in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Lord Jesus Christ. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth, work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine, work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Accept this sacrifice from your people, we pray, O Lord, and make what is offered for your glory in honour of Blessed Patrick a means of our eternal salvation. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For in the marvellous confession of your saints, you make your church fruitful with strength ever new, and offer us sure signs of your love. And that your saving mysteries may be fulfilled, their great example lends us courage, their fervent prayer sustains us in all that we do. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and the working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and the blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Saviour of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, on the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and the blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Patrick, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Joseph, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow in the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and
Saviour's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sin, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Lord, you know everything. You know that I love you. An act of spiritual communion. My
My Jesus, I believe that you are most truly present in the Eucharist. Although I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, help me to receive you spiritually into my life. Help me that I will always be close to you. Help me, followed by following the example of the saints, to be true to your Son, to be true to the Eucharist we celebrate, to the breaking of bread and the breaking of the world. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Let us pray. May the sacrament we have received, O Lord our God, stir up in us that fire of charity with which blessed Patrick burned ardently as he gave himself unceasingly for your church, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you for your participation in the Mass today, and especially those of you who hail from the Emerald Isle. I wish you all a very happy St. Patrick's Day, maybe a wee bit quieter than we would normally have. However, looking forward to better times ahead. I also remind you that the Novena will end on tomorrow evening at 7 o'clock, and very many of you have come forward and purchase candles for burning in your own home and also here in the church. The candles that have been left will be lit tomorrow evening and will burn through the night and for the Feast of St. Joseph on Friday. And we hope you can join us for the Novena tomorrow and for the Feast Day Mass on Friday. Hopefully the sound and everything else is okay, and those who follow us on YouTube will catch up in a wee while, because we hope to upload the recording of this Mass in the next wee while. But we'll be back onto the main sanctuary tomorrow morning for the Mass at 10 o'clock. So, as I say, even if it is a quiet one, have a happy St. Patrick's Day. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the Gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.